How about how in the 90s only cool girls could wear scrunchies?
What about Woods porn?
Wait a minute, what?
Wait a minute, what?
Wait a minute, what?
Nostalgia. Under the microscope.
Actually, no. I had never heard of Woods porn. I mean, I vaguely understood the trope, you know, kids skipping school, going into the woods to try and find some hidden stashes of nudie magazines, and then getting brutally murdered instead. I thought it was like an old cautionary tale. Don't go looking for porn in the woods, kids, or a haggard old man who lives in the forest might kidnap you forever. A simple urban legend to teach kids a lesson. I had no idea that woods porn itself was an actual thing.
You would like go to the woods and try to and find porn. It's a thing.
In case you're like me and you didn't grow up before the internet, woods porn is random stashes of porn hidden throughout the great American woods. By children and truthfully adults alike to maybe get lucky and stumble upon long before the internet reached every home. I pretty much grew up with dial-up, so if I wanted to ogle some body parts, all I needed to do was hijack the phone line and spend 30 minutes downloading a single picture. Who needs the woods when you've got that kind of computing power? I never truly lived the nightmare that Gen X and all generations before that lived. The pre-internet days when video games were just glorified moving pixels and there was no such thing as non-dairy milk. Not that I was cool enough to watch porn as a kid. I was too busy making my dolls kiss. But this idea that the American youth of yesteryear apparently couldn't help tripping over stacks of porn in the woods all the time felt like a fake story. Like some kind of 90s urban legend. Like one of those forwarding chains where it's like, you have been cursed by the love wizard. If you don't forward to 5 people, your crush will never fall in love with you. Only instead, if you go into the woods looking for porn, the Pope will haunt your dreams forever or something. Like, I don't know, I grew up with Catholic guilt. But the more I put my computer on incognito mode and Googled woods porn, the more I discovered this was a real thing. Apparently it was so common that so many men of a certain age have their own anecdote of finding porn in the woods, claiming porn in the woods, it's a thing.
Porn in the woods is a thing.
As an example, there are a handful of articles on the subject. I learned that tons of famous celebrities first saw a naked lady out in the woods. In this Playboy interview of Nathan Fillion from 2014, he says on his way to school, he'd bike through a field where there were 3 large pine trees with makeshift step boards on the side of them that you'd climb to reach the top, and when you did, you'd find a secret stash of Playboy magazines. In a passionate decry against internet porn in a self-written article for Playboy, Patton Oswalt longingly begs the reader to return to the good old days of finding a joyous stack of Playboys in the woods, saying that it's a rite of passage that is crucial for our nation's future, and indeed the future of our world. The joy, the satisfaction, and engaging of the 5 senses when one finds their own porno mags in the woods. It honestly sounds lovely. He then urges the reader to leave some magazines for future generations to come. See what I did there? Okay, gross. And finally, Will Wheaton.
Somebody get the smelling salts. I think I'm seeing double.
Will Wheaton, one of the many stars in Stand By Me, a film that seems to be built on the exact cautionary tale I mentioned earlier, in, coincidentally, an interview with Patton Oswalt, also for Playboy, mentions how he used to have to find his Playboys from his brother or another kid who had them and hid them in the woods. Well, it wasn't just a phenomenon that existed with men. Comedian Tig Notaro, in yet another interview with Playboy in 2015, says, "Well, I lived by a very underdeveloped area and there were a lot of woods out there. And there were Playboys stashed in those woods. And my friends and I would build forts in the woods. It was just me and my friends, girls. We were just like, what are these magazines?" All these interviews are for Playboy and all these interviews are about Playboys in the woods. It really makes you think about the naked magazines industrial complex. Playboy, is it you? Were you the ones leaving porn in the woods so that American children and wandering husbands would find them and spread the good word on woods porn? Or were kids just as horny before the internet and needed to find places to hide their physical stashes and leave them somewhere where mom wouldn't wander? I guess that makes total sense. Surprisingly, this concept is rarely depicted on screen, and it's more of a premise for larger plot lines, horror and adventure alike to unfold. Preteen 70s or 80s kids would go mess around in the woods, maybe look at some dirty magazines, and bam, a weird, haggled old man comes in and kills the vibe. Maybe you go in the woods for a veiled adventure and end up finding a dead body of a neighborhood boy. While I was hard-pressed for physical evidence outside of Playboy articles and anecdotes from Gen Xers sharing their stories, I did find tons of message boards where everyone says the same thing. Woods porn? It's common sense. You spend your days out hanging out with kids in the neighborhood, you're bound to end up in the woods, and you're bound to find someone's hidden stash of secret Playboys. It's just kind of taken for granted. A shared bonding experience for all you pre-internet, pre-pubescent folks. Maybe people think that it's less common than they think until they sit down and casually, woods porn comes up in conversation. Maybe it's embarrassing to remember the days as a preteen where you would spend your day searching and sweating through your remote suburban woods just to maybe peep an elusive body part or two. Maybe we are losing something with the internet. We're losing the appreciation of the hard work and reward. We're losing the sense of adventure, the camaraderie and loyalty among friends, the teamwork and brain power to undergo the most high-stakes scavenger hunt, the subtlety of a picture of a woman in a bikini as opposed to whatever the heck weird stuff you want at a click of a button. So go out there, adults, 18 or over, lace up your Converse shoes, adorn your best striped shirt and bomber jacket, and spend your day on a hike, but maybe it's actually a coveted and secret mission to find vintage Playboys in our nation's woods. Have you ever had a woods porn legend in your town? Let us know in the comments below and remember to like and subscribe. I hope this video is worth it for you because I think I ruined my YouTube algorithm. Incognito mode could only go so far. Coming up in my ads, some camping gear. No. Woods porn almost feels like it could be like a Goosebumps thing. And like goose humps.